I'm on my way to LAX right now to get on my flight to Portland. Let's go. Just got the TSA, now I'm going to go find the gate.
It's going to be 1 hour and 57 minutes of flight this morning. Welcome aboard.
Alright, I landed in Portland now. I'm first.
You're the first team
for a lead. So I can't actually stay at my Airbnb just yet, so I'm gonna drop off my bags. But I decided before I head off to the convention center, since there's still a couple hours before it opens for registration, I'm gonna go try out a place called Blend Coffee and see what it's like. Alright, now I'm gonna head over to the convention center. Alright, I just got to the convention center, so I'm gonna go check in and get my stuff.
Right here, we need two of you.
Hey, what's my ID?
We'll admit the swag is kind of weak this time. Yeah, I was really hoping to get another hat to add to my collection, but we pretty much just got a card and a mat. Kind of lame. I'm actually going to meet up with RC Cola and go grab some lunch. I'm not allowed in there today. Amazing. Wow. Well, look who it is. Say hello.
Hi.
I'm not up with RC. Here he is. He's coming to spectate for the weekend, enjoy himself.
I have some family in the area, so I was like, might as well hang out, come see some friends, you know.
Yeah, I didn't even know you were going to be here, so it's nice. And now I have an excuse to stay out here longer.
Yeah, I see right there. So the first day.
Clips of me eating.
Oh, yeah.
It's a mukbang.
Oh, no. Hello.
So I'm back in my Airbnb, and been racking my brain still for this tournament. I made a team earlier last month. I've been running it for the past month. So I guess what I'm trying to say is I have no idea how tomorrow is going to pan out, but I don't want to stress too much about it. I mean, this cycle's been a big learning curve for me in general, getting back into VGC. So I think the biggest thing I should take away is, regardless of how I feel preparation-wise, I'm gonna go into this tournament and just try my best with what I have. Alright, so I pretty much just decided to stick with what I was comfortable with, and here we are at the convention center now for the day of the tournament. Waiting for pairings to go live, but I'm feeling pretty good about today. Pairings are up, and I'm heading over to my table. Alright, I won round one, which is actually the first regional I've done this series where I've actually won the first round. So the competition is definitely going to get a lot tougher in my second round. Let's see if we can pull it off. Round two is now live, and I'm at table six. So this is definitely going to be extremely difficult. Alright, so round two is over, and he faced a wide guard Stonejourner, which was one thing I was not prepared to see I was hoping not to see any wide guard today at all, but Stone Turner in particular is a super good pick against my team, and my opponent played it super well, so GG's to them. Let's see what happens in round three. All right, so round three is up, and hopefully I can form a little bit better. I won the next round, so I'm 2-2. I didn't get a chance to record between the third and fourth because I was actually, we went to timer on the third match, and I never knew this. I always assumed whoever had the most Pokemon won the battle by timer, but it was actually, so I had three Pokemon left, my opponent had two, and it was Dondozo with Katsugiri inside of its stomach, and I was taunting their Dondozo with Gyarados, and it's paralyzed, and it's in the red, and I just assumed, oh, I'm going to win this because I have more Pokemon, so I was kind of like stalling out the match a bit. But then when the match ends, it ends up that they won because they had a total more HP. And I would have played slightly different in the end game if I would have realized this. I never knew this until this battle. I've been playing Pokemon for how long? It's crazy. But whatever.
All right, I won round five. There's four more rounds. I'm still in it right now. Just a lot of pressure on me. We'll see what happens. I'm 3-3 currently. And that was a really tough matchup. It went to game three. Really great plays. I mean, I'm not gonna say that this crit on my Orthworm was game-changing, but it definitely was unfortunate. But yeah, today a lot of the matches have actually been relatively winnable and manageable, and I feel really good about stuff regardless. It looks bad, you know, 3-3, right? But all my losses, aside my very first matchup against the Stonejourner, they were really good battles. They all went to game three and really sweaty battles. So I think my team overall can perform well, and even, you know, in different scenarios, if I rematch these same teams, I could probably get the W's. It will go back and forth all day long, probably. So yeah, I'm feeling pretty good about this. I'm going to try to clear it out. My goal today was to go 6-3 to try to do my best run this cycle. So yeah, we'll see how it goes. All right, so I just played the most insane matchup today. And yes, believe it or not, it was, in fact, like, it's hard to explain. I feel like I had very small margin of room to win this set. And our second match went to timer. I did learn from my earlier match about the HP total, so I played that accurately and I won by timer. I lost the first match, won the second one. And third one, my opponent made all these amazing plays at the very beginning of the fight, and I just thought, oh man, it's over. But I just kept playing through the match, and I ended up securing the win in the end. I'm 4-3 now, and I'm gonna play out the rest of my matches and try to get some championship points. I end up going 4-4 now. It's definitely been an extremely difficult tournament, but I feel really good about it still. I'm just gonna play my final match and try to just tie my best record so far. We'll see. All right, so I finished the tournament. I ended up going 5-4, which is tied with my best run so far. Honestly, I feel very good about this run. The competition during this tournament was definitely more intense, in my personal opinion, and I have a really good sense of how I'm functioning as a BGC player in this current format. So even though I went 5-4, I genuinely feel like I've learned a lot today, and I'm going to take that experience and apply it towards my run at Fresno. Now we need to go get a drink.
Gotta make it organic like we're not here. What's up, YouTube?
I'll put that part in.
We're here. We're here in Portland. Caleb is a high skill player running Bastiodon, obviously.
Yeah, I mean, he's proven it.
Solid low skill player running that.
So I still have a couple days here in Portland, and honestly, I'm just going to spend it eating some good food. Thanks for tuning into this video today. If you enjoyed seeing this perspective of a Pokemon regional, definitely consider liking, commenting, subscribing, and enjoy this little montage of just me enjoying some stuff in Portland.
before I leave, I just kind of take notes.
I forgot. Oh, hello there. Oh, it's a cute cat. With that being said, the Sasquatch thing is strong each and every morning, evening, afternoon, between, and I'll catch you in the next one.